The Philippine Immigration Bureau is sending 147 newly hired immigration officers to the Ninoy Aquino International Airport starting April 24. Their assignment at the country's main gateway will be part of their on-site training in time for the peak summer travel season. They will be later assigned to different airports and immigration offices nationwide. Immigration Commissioner Norman Tansinko says new personnel will undergo further trainings, including communication and conflict resolution. The LRT2 Marikina Pasig Station is now open, which links the train line to a nearby mall. This provides comfort for commuters who no longer have to exit the mall to reach the LRT station. Karen De Guzman gives us a look.
The LRT2 Marikina Pasig Station and Santa Lucia Mall Link is now open to the public. On Tuesday, the Department of Transportation, together with the Light Rail Transit Authority and the Santa Lucia Land Incorporated, led the ribbon-cutting ceremony that connects the said mall to the LRT station. The link aims to provide easy passenger transfer coming from different establishments. Prior to the opening of the said link, commuters have to walk for around 15 minutes from the mall to the train station. Now, they enjoy the convenience of using the said connector.
Mas mapapadali po yung pag-travel po namin kasi po may shortcut na po papuntang Santolo. And bali po mag-ano na lang po kami, jeep pa-uwi.
Siyempre masaya po kasi for us, mas magiging convenient po yung travel. And yung mas ano, hindi na siya mainit. Kasi diba from before ito, parang lalabas ka pa, tapos mainit, marami ding tao. So, yun, masaya.
This will not only benefit the train station, but also the mall that will attract mall goers. The LRT2 Marikina Pasig Station serves an average of 14,000 passengers daily, and this new link will help commuters to save their time and increase productivity.
The Land Transportation Office wants to streamline more processes to benefit motorists. The agency has formed a technical working group to review services that can be further rationalized. LTO Chief J.R. Tugade says they are looking to bring improvements in several policies, including insurance requirements and exams given to drivers. He adds this is in line with their efforts to fully digitalize transactions. Tugade also says they're seeking the help of law enforcement agencies to eradicate fixers in the agency.
Masusi po nilang pinag-aaralan kung ano pa po ang pwede nating baguhin, ano pa po ang pwede nating i-compress, ano pa po ang pwede nating i-improve doon po sa existing policies at sistema po natin upang sa ganoon po mas mapadali, mas mapabilis, mas mapagaan po ang buhay ng ating mga kababayan.
The Philippine Water Board assures Metro Manila consumers of enough water supply during the dry season. The agency says the current level at the Angat Dam, one of the main sources of water in the capital region, remains normal. The public, however, is still encouraged to conserve water due to the looming El Nino phenomenon.
Sa tingin po natin na may sapat tayong supply ng tubig para po sa kababayan natin. Particular po itong panahon ng tag-init. No? Kaya lang po, kailangan din po natin ipunin ito at i-conserve, magkaroon ng conservation ng supply po natin para po mapaghandaan, no, itong threat po o pagamba natin dito sa El Nino.